It's been really key for us to have an automated infrastructure so that we can test upgrades, so that we can iterate, so we have better agility. Hi, I'm Bob Meier. I manage digital platforms at Takeda Pharmaceuticals.
Hi, my name is Paul Jacobs. I'm a technical account manager with UiPath, and I work with Takeda very closely on their RPA journey. Bob, why don't you give us a thumbnail sketch of what the Takeda UiPath RPA journey is like?
Oh, definitely. So Takeda started working with UiPath about 3 years ago. We started with one automation, a simple manually configured orchestrator, and we've grown to dozens and then hundreds of automations over time, including a citizen program that we've now trained over 500 citizens. Paul, do you want to talk a little bit about how we've adapted our infrastructure over time and automated it?
Sure. As of the moment, we have a legacy AWS environment, but we're making a big push into the Takeda Enterprise Cloud, which is an infrastructure as cloud effort, which will allow all of the servers to be built in a prescribed fashion and a completely automated fashion. So in order to do that, we're making heavy use of a thing called the AWS Quick Starts, the Orchestrator Quick Starts, and those have been a real blessing for us. The environment that we're going to is complex. It's an HA multi-node orchestrator environment with full Redis, load balancers, the whole nine yards. So the fact that the Quick Start templates exist and build out the environment from the ground up is a real savings for us, and it's a great thing. It's allowed us a terrific foundation upon which to build. We've learned a few things as we go. You have to be a little careful. This kind of development can be a little slow, so you have to make sure that you budget enough time. You're likely to run into things like hardened AMIs, so make sure that you have a good sense for that. In addition, once you get the environment up, you want to go through and do some testing to see whether or not you want to change any of the parameters for auto-scaling and things like along those lines to make sure that your environment is performing well. But we're really looking forward to having a much more aggressive server-based environment in place.
Yeah, Paul, the work you've done has been amazing. It's been really key for us to have an automated infrastructure so that we can test upgrades, so that we can iterate, so we have better agility, not just in how we apply automation, but in how we manage automation. So the quick starts and the support of UiPath and leveraging these quick starts has really helped us accelerate to the latest features and latest versions of UiPath.
It's been really nice finally being able to meet you in person in the pandemic times. You sit at home and you don't get a chance to put faces to names, but it's been wonderful to meet you in person, and it'll be good to get back and get working on our effort again.
I agree. After what feels like hundreds of Teams calls, like
right.
To finally meet you in person is really fantastic. I think Forward has been great for bringing my team together for the first time.